Welcome back, Irish fans, to UND.com. They have released the official Notre Dame men's basketball schedule today, and here to break it down with us is Irish head coach Mike Brey. And again, another challenging schedule, and you start quickly, including your two exhibition games. You play 10 games in November.
Yeah, it's a busy November for us, but I think, you know, when you get through 3 weeks of practice, guys want to start playing, and that's the way to evaluate our team. And the great thing about college basketball is you can learn about your team. You can take some bullets, so to speak, in November and December. And the Big East regular season always gives you, as we've proven, enough opportunities to play your way into an NCAA tournament bid.
And you're in another tournament this year, the CBE tournament down in Kansas City, highlighted by a Monday night, November 21st game with Missouri. And the next night, you'll play one of two teams you're familiar with, either Cal or Georgia.
Yeah, that's going to be a heck of a tip-off. And, you know, Kansas City's got a great basketball tradition from way back in the NAI days. It is a basketball city. People are excited about us coming down there. Of course, we've got that neutral site game against your alma mater, Missouri. That will be interesting, and a very good team. As you said, Cal and Georgia, we had to fight through last year. Hopefully, if Cal and us play, it's not as ugly a game as it was last year in Orlando. But the Sprint Center is beautiful. I think there'll be great crowds. It'll certainly be a road atmosphere for us against Missouri on that Monday night, but a great challenge.
Something tells me you're going to remind me about my alma mater a number of times in the coming weeks, but no split loyalties, trust me. Then the next week, a long pre-conference road trip on out to Spokane, where you're going to take on Gonzaga.
Well, back to Spokane into a really, they have a great home basketball environment. That will be a good, true test of us playing on the road, and it'll give me a feel for our group on what are we going to be like on the road and what do we need to do better before we get into 9 Big East road games. But they've got a lot back. Certainly, we were fortunate enough to beat them here. I know that town. I've talked to so many people when I was recruiting in the West this summer. That town can't wait for us to come to town, so that's going to be a great night.
And the challenges in your non-conference schedule, every game, of course, a challenge. You have nightmares, especially among some of the teams people expect you to beat, because you never know in college basketball, but you do have to, another road game of sorts, Maryland in the BB&T, and you're going to go down to Indianapolis and play Indiana.
Yeah, again, how about those two neutral site games, too? Maryland and D.C., Indiana.
You got to work on that.
I don't know how we're doing that, but, I mean, those will be tough games, again, because they will have the majority of the building. I think we're excited to play Indiana again and play down there in Indianapolis. We've recruited this state, you know, hard and pretty well in my 11 years, so I think it's important for that reason. And I think our fans down that way, that's a great day of basketball with Butler and Purdue. Anytime we go to D.C. to play in the, you know, down there against Maryland or Georgetown, we've always had a great following, and we've played really well in that building. I'll tell you another game that's really going to be a real challenge for us, Detroit. When Detroit is picked to win their league, they've got a great guard who's the son of their coach, Ray McCallum. We have got our hands full right out of the gate in game two, playing Detroit here at 9 o'clock on a Monday night.
So after that challenging non-conference schedule, the first night of Big East action is Tuesday the 27th of December for the league, and you guys are playing on that very first night. You're going to host Pittsburgh.
We are the leadoff game, the kickoff game for Big East basketball, and Pitt and Notre Dame, there's been some great games, and it's been a great series. We've had a nice little run on them lately. I believe we've won 3 in a row, but they will come in loaded again. They have been the most consistent program in the Big East in my 11 years. I think we've been closely right behind them in consistency, and we're proud of that. But when you look at how we start off the Big East, you know, we better be ready. Christmas will be spent here on the practice floor this year.
And certainly for fans who want that powerful home schedule, 3 of your first 4 home games are Pittsburgh, UConn, and Syracuse.
I mean, there it is right there. That's just an example of the league we play in. And, you know, the good news is you're in the Big East. The bad news is you're in the Big East sometimes when I look at that schedule. But for our fans to see those teams coming in right after Christmas, boy, we are going to need our fans. We're going to need energy in the building because and this building, Jack, has been good to us. We've been undefeated 3 of the last 5 years. No other program has done that. Duke and Kansas, 2 of the last 5 years at home. So we need to keep that home kind of situation going and momentum going.
And for the second time, your senior night, your final home game, will be on a Friday night, March 2nd, when Providence comes to town.
Well, and that'll be a special night when a Tim Abramitis and a Scott Martin will be honored, because those two young men have done so much for our program. You think about Tim being here 5 years. You know, I don't know if he's teaching classes this year. The guy's been unbelievable. What? I don't know if there's a better role model in college athletics than Tim Abro as a student athlete. It's just an amazing story. And it's a great story as how he's developed as a basketball player, getting better every year. Scott Martin, you know, an in-state kid that transferred to us. And I think he's going to have a big senior year.
You've played a lot of tough schedules to the point now you don't flinch anymore. I talked about schedule. You just kind of shrug and go, it's tough. It's the Big East. We expect this. But how does this one compare to some of the ones you've played recently?
You know, I think this was right up there with the toughest of our schedules. It may not be the toughest, but I think it's in my 11 years, it's got to be in the top two or three. And when I look back through them or think back through them with what we're doing in the non-league, where we're playing people, the neutral site games, which really aren't neutral, and we're going to have to play against a road crowd. And then our league now, our league is the best league. It's the best league. It's the hardest league. It's the greatest challenge. It really excites my staff and our players to play the Big East and have that challenge weekly.
You lost some very talented players off of last year's team. Under NCAA rules now, you now do have some contact with your kids on a weekly basis now that school's back in session. Just give us some of your early thoughts on the team you'll be putting on the floor this year.
Well, we did lose some men, there's no question. And where last year we were a finished product on the first day of practice with those five seniors, those guys were ready to go. I have to remind ourselves, me and our staff and our players, that we need to be patient as we figure this group out by the time the Big East starts. But certainly when you start with two fifth-year senior captains in Scott Martin and Tim Abramitis, you know, that's a great place to start. I think Eric Atkins will make a big leap now that it will be his team, it will be his ball, he's the quarterback. Jack Cooley has helped us win big games. His role becomes more increased, and I believe he's ready for it. So those are four guys that have been in the battles you'll feel good about. Now, who do we add to that party? I'm excited about evaluating Alex Dragovich. He has looked good in our workouts, you know, here early in this fall semester. We're going to need him. We lost shooting and ball handling. He brings both to the table. Jaron Grant, who we redshirted last year in athletics, slashing, slicing, ability to shoot at guard. I think that's another guy that is part of the equation. Joey Brooks as a defender and a stopper and maybe one of the most athletic guys on our team. And as a man, we need to find a role for him, and he needs to keep working toward that. Mike Brohammer getting healthy. Tom Knight getting healthy. I want to evaluate those guys. Those guys are still a little sore. Knight's in better shape. Brohammer still recovering until October 1st. But, you know, probably more than any year I've been here, other than three or four guys, I don't know what's going to be the rest of the rotation. And that's kind of exciting. And I think it's exciting for our players because they know I got a shot at this thing. So really compete through the fall.
It is going to be an exciting year. And remember, UND.com is your home for the best coverage of the Notre Dame basketball program. We have Coach's weekly TV show. He does exclusive updates for us each and every week. And all of the non-televised home games will be seen live right here on UND.com. Good luck, Coach. Thank you.
Thank you. Here we go. Go Irish.
With Coach Brey, I'm Jack Nolan, UND.com.